Hey, this is Tyler from SpectraCal, now a part of Portrait Displays. In this video, I'm going to walk you through our new HDR10 calibration workflow. The workflow is intended for calibration and measurement of HDR10 compatible TVs. I've opened the workflow. This is the splash page. The next page is where we connect our hardware. I've already connected our SpectraCal C6 and Quantum Data 780 pattern generator. Now we need to enable HDR10 mode, so I'm going to go here and click HDR10, and that's going to send the proper metadata via HDMI to the TV to kick it into HDR mode. Now we default to 1000 nits and P3 color gamut of the mastering display. You can put in your own metadata values if you want to evaluate how your television behaves with different HDR10 metadata. We recommend using a 10% window pattern. This applies to both LCDs and OLEDs. This is also the same size that the Ultra HD Alliance uses in their testing protocols. The next page is our pre-calibration view. This should be pretty familiar to you if you've used CalMAN before. We've tried to keep the mechanics of the calibration very similar to an SDR calibration. Some of the graphs might be scaled a little different or have different labels, but you should be pretty familiar with the process. I'm going to do a read series so we can see what it's doing right now. Now we've measured both our color gamut and the grayscale. The next page in the workflow is a two-point white balance page. Since HDR10 is a new technology, different manufacturers of the televisions have implemented controls differently, and so there are some different behaviors. Some displays you would do two-point white balance, some you don't, so there's going to be a kind of learning curve for the whole calibration community to figure out the best way to calibrate each of the manufacturers. So this is our two-point white balance. The next page is the multi-point grayscale. Now, this should look pretty familiar, but we do have these two new graphs. Instead of a gamma graph, we have an EOTF graph, which stands for electro-optical transfer function, which in this case we're using ST2084, which is the transfer function that's used for HDR10. Once I take some measurements, I'll explain what we see in this graph. And we also have this peak luminance graph, so you can see an easy representation of how bright that your HDR10 TV actually is. So I'm going to do a read series, and then afterwards I'm going to explain what these new graphs are showing. So the EOTF graph, it's pretty much following right along ST2084. If it was any of these points were under luminance, the line would come down below this line. If it was over luminanced at that point, it would be above. And then near the top, this is the highlight roll-off feature. So each manufacturer is doing the roll-off a little bit differently. It's not a standard yet. The ITU is working on a standard to how and at what rate you should roll off the highlights. You don't want to hard clip anything. So each manufacturer is kind of doing things a little bit differently. So we can't have an actual roll-off standard to measure against at the very top until the ITU comes out with their recommendation. So that's what we're seeing right here and right here. So you can see it's following the ST2084 curve very nice until the roll-off starts. In the normal RGB balance chart, in this area it's a little bit over-luminanced, and then this is where the roll-off starts. So this is normal looking. Don't be freaked out because this is a big spike down. This is just where the roll-off starts happening. And you can see the peak luminance of this particular HDR10 display is 550 nits, or about 547. The next page is our color management page. Now, by default, previously, we would measure 100% saturation in SDR calibrations. That's what we've always been calibrating. Rec 709 and our regular calibrations are now considered SDR. It's kind of like we never knew we were watching standard def TV until high def TV came out. It was just TV before that. Then we had high definition. Then we started calling the previous thing standard definition. So SDR is standard dynamic range versus HDR, which is high dynamic range. So since our color space for HDR10 is Rec 2020, and no displays can actually hit Rec 2020, save for something like RGB laser projector, because Rec 2020's primaries are single wavelengths of light. That's why they're on the spectral locus right here. That's the very edge. Each one of the primaries is actually a single wavelength of laser light. We're not going to be able to hit that with a flat panel, most of the displays can cover some percentage of Rec 2020. So we've set this up to measure Rec 2020 at 50% saturation and 50% luminance. Because if we did 100% luminance, that would be equal to 10,000 nits, because ST2084, 100% signal is 10,000 nits. So whatever the color representation of that would be. So we can't measure it at 100% saturation, 100% luminance. So we're doing something that most displays can hit, which is 50% saturation and 50% luminance. I'll run a quick read series, and then I want to show you some new features we've added to our saturation sweeps that I think people are really going to like. This layout, what we call a workflow page, is a layout. This is actually a saturation sweep page that I've selected 50% saturated, 50% luminance on, but there are some alternative ones that you can pick that I think people will be kind of excited about. So I'll show you that after I take the measurements. Okay, so you can see this is our 50% saturation. We got pretty good delta E's, they're all about 3 or under. But the alternative saturation sweeps I wanted to talk about is we added something where, even though we're set to Rec 2020 in here, under workflow basic options, we're set to Rec 2020 ST2084. So that's our target. We added a new feature in our saturation sweeps. So I can go to workflow basic options here, go to saturation sweeps, and I can pick DCI-P3 based sweeps inside of Rec 2020 and signaled as Rec 2020. So you can see how it tracks DCI-P3 saturations and primaries inside of a Rec 2020 container. Let me switch this to 20%. As many people have heard, and there's been a lot of buzz about it, even though we're signaling Rec 2020, the mastering displays that have been mastering the HDR content at the studios, most of their gamut is P3. But since P3 isn't a standard for home video at all, we're kind of transporting that P3 data in a Rec 2020 container signaled as Rec 2020 RGB triplets. This right here is the P3 red signaled as a Rec 2020 triplet. It has the XYZ value of the P3 red, but signaled in Rec 2020 triplets. I can show you what the results would be when I run this. Kind of an interesting test. So now we've ran our sweeps. You could see it follows the P3 primary saturation sweep inside of Rec 2020 pretty well until it has to clip, because this display does not do 100% of P3. I think it does somewhere around 90% or a little over 90%. So you can see also it follows the green primary of P3 until it can't hit 100% of P3. Also the blue primary, you can see the native blue primary of this display is actually outside of Rec 2020, but it's not all the way over to the spectral locus. So it's further down, but it's not the Rec 2020 blue. So that's why when it gets to the edge, it has to start going towards the native primary. So it can follow, and then it starts to go towards the native primary. One other thing that we've added for saturation sweeps for HDR, or you could use it for SDR as well, is Rec 2020 contained Rec 709 saturation sweeps as well. So I can go here, and I can do the same test, but with Rec 709, to see how Rec 709 signaled colors in a Rec 2020 container would actually behave. So I could do a saturation sweep for the Rec 709 primaries. Okay, now that we've ran through our CMS here, this is our post-calibration settings. After you did your cuts and gains or 10-point or CMS adjustments, you would document those. And then the next thing would be to do our color checker. In the color checker, all these values are signals of Rec 2020, but they're all the color checker SDR content. We felt that since most of the content in HDR, even though it can be much wider color gamut and brighter, that most of the content in the movie will be in the Rec 709 area and in the 100 nit range, and then you'll just get explosions and other really wide stuff more sparsely throughout the content. And we also have the DCI-P3 primaries in this color checker. And then the color checker, the data from here will be populated into the report. So I'm going to run a read series. Now that I've done the color checker, We have the saturation sweep page. It's already configured. The other one was just configured for the 50% and 50%. This one is set up for the Rec 2020 sweeps. We just thought it would be easier so you didn't have to keep going in the menu to include both of them. So I'm just going to leave this blank since we already covered the different saturation sweep options. So now is our post-calibration view. This is where you would take your measurements to see how accurate your display is after you did all the calibration. Now, I'm just kind of walking you through these pages. I didn't show you the calibration process. We'll be showing more videos like that. So we're pretty much going to have the same results as our pre-calibration measurements. But this will be populated into our new home HDR report. So let me run a read series really quick so we can populate that data, and then I can launch the home HDR report to show you that. Because the existing home report, the graphs aren't configured correctly for HDR. So we wanted to give you guys something that you could post online. Okay, so now I'm gonna go to view report, save session and view report. So this is our new HDR home report. So it shows our RGB balance, our EOTF graph, delta E's of the grayscale, and then our color checker results. One cool thing about this report, and the reason that it's not labeled the CalMAN HDR10 home report, is because it's also compatible with the Dolby Vision workflow. Currently, the enthusiast license doesn't get the professional Dolby Vision report, so we wanted to give you an alternative for the home user. So this report is compatible with both the HDR10 workflow and the Dolby Vision workflow. Thanks for watching this video, and don't forget, please subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if your all access is expired, make sure you renew it to get the latest and greatest features in CalMAN.